Hello friends, today let's see how to make chocolate chip cookies with ragi or finger millet flour. Very easy, simple recipe, very healthy recipe, gluten free recipe and tasty too. You'll never be able to find out that you made this out of ragi. It's very easy to sneak in ragi to kids with these recipes. Come, let's see how to make this. I have 2 tablespoons of ghee here. To this, I'm adding 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda. And I'm going to mix it well till it is fluffy and light. Now to this, I'm adding 1/2 cup of ragi flour. I have sifted this ragi flour and then measured. A pinch of salt so that the sugar taste is enhanced. 2 tablespoons of unsweetened cocoa powder. If you have sweetened cocoa powder, you can reduce the amount of sugar accordingly. I'm using this unsweetened cocoa powder. I have 1/4 cup of almond flour. Blanch the almonds, dry them and pulse them in the mixer grinder. You will get 1/4 cup, around 20 almonds, medium sized almonds. I have 1/4 cup of milk powder. One tablespoon of corn flour. And 1/4 cup of unrefined sugar. You can use sugar or palm sugar or whatever sweet you want. And here comes our yummy ingredient, chocolate chips. I'm adding around 2 tablespoons of chocolate chips. There is no limit when it comes to chocolate. You can add how much ever you want. Mix well. Here I have 1 teaspoon of sabja seeds mixed with 1.5 tablespoons of water and kept ready. This takes about 10 minutes to soak up. Now these sabja seeds they are also called as sweet basil seeds or tukmariya. It is easily available in the shops. It is a very good moisture retaining agent. See, just 1 teaspoon of it, how much it has swollen up to. So it retains good amount of moisture. Now since we are using gluten-free flour here, this doesn't retain moisture very well and they tend to become dry. So that is the reason why I am using this. Now in case you don't have this, you can even use 2 tablespoons of apple puree. Just put the remove the skin of the apple, put it in a mixer grinder, blend it well and you can add for the moisture or you can even add 1 tablespoon of coconut flour or 2 tablespoons of banana puree. Any of these things you can add so that this retains good moisture. I have 1/4 cup of milk here too. Now apart from this, if we need, we are going to add milk and make this into a dough. Now I'm adding this sabja seed mixer. You will not taste it in a weird manner in the cookie at all. This gets well blended with the flour. Now mix well with the sabja seeds or the sweet basil seeds and then if required add milk. Kids will never know that you have added ragi in this at all because everything is brown in color and the taste also will be similar to the regular chocolate chip cookie. So this is a nice way to sneak in ragi into their diet if they don't like it. Ragi is very healthy for kids. with lots of calcium in it and iron in it. It's good for elders too. We ladies can have this without any guilt because it's gluten free with very little fat and all healthy ingredients. Now we mixed with the sweet basil seeds or the sabja seeds well. Now to this I'm going to add little by little milk and then make it into a smooth dough. It is better to use hands here because you will know the consistency better. I have used only half of the quarter cup of milk. Now we have a smooth dough here. I have not used any more milk at all, only half of the quarter cup of milk. So let this stay for 5 minutes. Now it's almost 10 minutes now. I told you to give resting time because we have added the sabja seeds. If it absorbs even more moisture, then if need be, we can add some more milk. But the quantity what we added is enough. Grease your palms a little bit with oil or butter or ghee. I have greased a cookie plate and made it ready. I'm going to make cookies. Now this you can make it of any desired shape. You can even use a cookie cutter if you want. I'm going to use the whole dough and make chocolate chip cookies. I'm preheating the oven to 160 degrees centigrade. I was able to make 6 choco chip cookies of this size. Now I'm going to add a little bit of choco chips on top. I'm adding white as well as brown chocolate chips just for the color combo. I'm going to press it slightly so that it sticks to the top. The oven is preheated and ready. I'm going to bake these for 15 minutes. Now they are cooked and ready. Let them cool for some time. These are well cooked and crisp. I like hot choco chip cookies. I'm going to taste one now. Cool for some time. Now the chocolate chips are cooled completely. You can see that they look like regular chocolate chip cookies. And they taste like regular chocolate chip cookies too. So here we have a healthy, gluten-free, less fat, tasty, calcium-rich, iron-rich, ragi flour chocolate chip cookies or finger millet chocolate chip cookies. Simple, easy and original recipe. Oven temperatures vary, so please vary the temperature accordingly, according to your oven. So here we have a tasty cookies. See, they look like normal cookies. Very, very crispy, tasty. If you want it to be chewy, take it 2 or 3 minutes before the required time. If you want crisp cookies, you can keep it 15 to 20 minutes according to your oven timings. Thanks for watching. Please like my video, share this video, give me your feedback, and subscribe to my channel.